Yeah, God bless you. I see we are, by the help of God, we are set to go. Yes, good morning, sir. Yes. This one does not require. Good morning, Daddy.
Right, Simon, it shall be well with you.
Amen, Daddy.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Please help me greet that angel sitting next to you. I shall be well with her.
She's greeting you back, sir.
It is well with you.
Welcome. Amen, Dad. Amen,
thank
sir.
You. Okay.
Yes, so sir.
I'm with you.
Okay, sir.
It's your beautiful, my essence, and my energy.
Good morning, good morning. This is the day the Lord has made. We are glad and we rejoice. We are grateful for such an opportunity to celebrate life, growth, and development at the instance of Mr. Simon Aranonu, who out of the largeness of his heart put together this book, Financial Freedom, Steps to Debt-Free Living, to ensure that people like myself who need to borrow money from time to time don't get belabored by debt, but we know how to manage money, handle finances, service our debt right. Out of the fullness of his heart, he has shared of his knowledge. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to say welcome. And welcome. My name is Joyce Daniels. I'll be your MC today. Thank you so much for being here and being here on time. You will find that it is you're unable to unmute yourselves. That is intentional by the host of the event to make sure that we reduce distractions and that the few minutes that we are gathered here together will run seamlessly, quickly, and as planned. Pastor Kelajai Johnson is here to lead us in the opening prayer. He is the regional evangelist and special assistant on evangelism to the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Please, everyone, welcome him with me as he leads us in the opening prayer.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are grateful to God for the gift of this day. I want to congratulate my brother for a job well done. I used to say before now that if you want the bank to leave you alone, don't take bank loan. But after reading his book, I changed my mind. So let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we want to say thank you to you, sir. We are grateful to you for great and mighty things you've done for us. Lord, we thank you because we are not in the mortuary. We are not in the graveyard. We appreciate your love and kindness. We thank you for your intervention. We thank you for your protection and guidance over us. Father, please accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We know we are deficient without you. We can do nothing, absolutely nothing without you. Yes. My Lord, we ask you to please take absolute control within this time that we're going to spend together as a family. My Lord, take control in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everything we are going to do today, my Lord, please direct us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At the end, my Lord, take all the glory in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And your son and your daughter that you are using for us, my Lord, we pray that you will continue to replenish them. You'll continue to bless them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
My Lord, I use this opportunity to commit all this, your children, unto you. That year 2020, we never see our end in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what is going on out there. In Jesus' name, nobody will bury you this year. And you will not bury any member of your families this year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, my Father, for answered prayers. For in Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, sir. We are grateful. Indeed, we are. And we thank God for you who has been here, been such a strong support. Thank you. I know that even as a child, it was said over and over again that it takes a village. It still takes a village, not just to raise children, but to ensure that good things happen and are spread across the nation. Thank you, sir. The chairman, Bank of Industry, a strong supporter of our author today, a man who believes in the development of people and institutions, will be welcomed up right now to lead us in the opening remarks. If your hands are there, even though you are muted, please put your hands together as we welcome the one and the only Malam Aliyu Diko. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, MC. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor and privilege for me to give the opening remarks this morning during the presentation of the book, Financial Freedom, written by Simon Aronono. Simon is one of the most versatile top management staff that we have in the bank. So anytime he is doing anything, I'll be most interested to be part of it. And it is a privilege for me to present the short opening remarks this morning. I have gone through the book, Financial Freedom, Secrets of Debt-Free Living. And from my reading of the book and understanding of the book can be summarized in three words: discipline, prudence, independence is equal to financial freedom. From the content of the book will be useful to credit officers in banks for counseling and advising their clients. The book also will be useful for risk management officers to guide in their appraisal of credit. It will also be a useful tool for corporate organizations in trying to meet requirements by banks for loan applications. It will be very useful to cooperative societies in managing their cooperatives. The book, above all, will be a very useful tool to households in managing their finances. The book, in summary, is a major contribution to humanity. I therefore recommend the book to the general public. Thank you very much, and well done to you all. Well done to you, Simon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Alhaji Malam Aliyu Diko. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We appreciate you for your efforts and giving us the opening remarks. Allow me to quickly recognize some of our guests who are here. They are members of the board of directors of the Bank of Industry. For those who may not know, which I doubt, that is where our author for today has been for several years and has been a blessing to many people and serves as executive director of large enterprises. his colleagues and former colleagues who are here, please allow me mention names. And wherever you are, just wave your hands. Hopefully, at some point, the camera will be able to spotlight you and we'll celebrate your presence. Alhaji Mohammed Bintube would like to say thank you for being here and your constant support. Mr. Alexander Adeyemi, we appreciate your presence. Thank you so much. Engineer Chukwuemeka Nzewi, thank you, thank you, thank you for being here. Mr. Philip Yusuf Yila, we appreciate you. Thank you, sir. Alhaji Tijani Babura, thank you for your support. And our executive directors here present who are still serving at the Bank of Industry, Mr. Jonathan Tobin, we appreciate your presence. Mrs. Toyin Adeniji, thank you so much. Malam Omar Shikaru, thank you, thank you, and thank you. Without you, today's event will not be complete. Sitting at the helm of affairs of the Bank of Industry is a man given to progress and development of people and the bank itself. So many things have changed for the better since he came on board, and we are happy, glad, and honored that today he will welcome us officially to this book presentation. He is the Managing Director of the Bank of Industry. Please join me. Welcome, Mr. Olukayode Piton. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Good morning to everybody. It gives me great pleasure to be with all of us this morning. Like my chairman already told us, the writer of the book, Pastor Simon Aranonu, is a valuable member of the board of BOI, and he has done a lot, you know, in moving the bank forward. But this morning, my job is very easy, is to welcome everybody and talk slightly about the book. I know we're going to have book reviewers, so we are going to have it reviewed in depth. But this book, Financial Freedom, it's a very good book for the small and medium enterprises and individuals in particular, because there are many things it talks about, what to do in order to avoid the debt bondage, how to pay off your debt if you're already in debt, how to build wealth, you know, how to preserve wealth, and how to achieve lifetime financial freedom, which is what everybody wants to achieve. And I pray that it be the decision for all of us who are part of this book launch. So, like I said again, you're all welcome. And we want to congratulate Mr. Adonu, you know, a very versatile person, like my chairman has said, with over 30 years of experience in the financial industry, and who has been a tremendous blessing to every institution where he had worked. How he finds time to do everything, only God knows. So again, congratulations and welcome to everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. How he finds time to do everything, only God knows indeed. He's so committed. Thank you so much, sir. And that is Mr. Olukayode Piton, Managing Director, Bank of Industry. We appreciate your presence, sir. For some of us who have not encountered the book, because I know that quite a number have since earlier in the year, sometime in March, when we were getting ready for the book presentation, then, but due to what happened globally, it was postponed until God has favored us to give us this time now. We'll watch a video right now to introduce us and tell us more about the book. Please keep your eyes on the screen.
Financial Freedom is an extremely unique book. What makes this book very unique is that for years, for generations, we have been training finance people, educating them, and trying to instill in them the skills that they need on how to lend money, how to ensure they support people who are borrowers and ensure that the money gets paid back. That's all we've been learning in the credit school for generations. Well, for the first time, in my personal opinion, with all this sense of humility, we are writing to consumers. We are writing to borrowers. We want to educate people who borrow money, who have to manage their assets so that they can be able to have a knowledge that will assist them on how to be able to use borrowed money if they must borrow. And if they don't have need to borrow, they need to know how to manage wealth so that they don't have need to borrow. And if they must borrow, the things they must do to ensure that they discharge the obligations as and when they fall due. So you can call this like a 360 degree training, where for the first time we have been training those who lend. Now we want to train those who borrow. We want people to have knowledge about how money works. We want people to know how to be responsible in the use of money and understand money. Actually, that's a chapter in the book called Understanding Finance, you know, which is the chapter that focuses on teaching people the finance language that seems to be the exclusive preserve of bankers and finance people, which I had to break down in simple market woman's language, so to speak, so that everyone who is not in the banking or finance world will be able to understand money and how it works and understand how to use it and how to preserve it and how to build it and how to be able to know when to borrow if you must borrow, and how to be able to use borrowed money when you borrow. And if you don't need to borrow, you need to know how to preserve what you have so that you can be able to retain a standard of living that can carry you up to retirement, you know, so you can leave a good legacy for your children.
Thank you. To be able to leave a good legacy, even if you have borrowed, know how to manage the money well enough. Words from the author himself. And I can't wait for you to experience the book. Like he said, written in English as simple for the market man or market woman. If your hands are there, please put your hands together for our author and this laudable project. Thank you. To give us comments on the book is a man I like to call a finance man, a true money man. He has been in banking for decades actively, and even after leaving active banking, he's still very present in the money and finance space. He is a former deputy governor of the Central Bank, and he is currently the chairman of Fidelity Bank. Please join me, receive Mr. Ernest AB.
Good morning, everyone. Indeed, it gives me a great pleasure to once again join this distinguished audience on this auspicious occasion of the presentation of another brilliant book by a very good friend of mine, somebody I have known for over 30 years, all in the financial services space. And I want to join all the previous speakers in congratulating him for this very auspicious book. And this is called Financial Freedom, Secrets of Debt-Free Living. A few months ago, before the COVID-19 imposed lockdown, we gathered like this, though that one was physically, not by virtual meeting, to present his book, his first book, Solutions Capsules, which I believe now must be a bestseller. And today again, we gathered to present another book, which I believe speaks to the moment, things that are happening at the moment, and that is it's been topical talking about debt in the last few months in our country here. Recently, I just read an article yesterday in the Guardian called "Modern Slaves Are Not in Chains; They Are in Debt." Mm. Just recently, also the Central Bank of Nigeria introduced the Global Standing Instruction (GSI) policy to deal with recalcitrant debtors in banks. And the policy makes it more compelling and imperative for people to embrace this book to liberate themselves from financial bondage. Again, this book is not only for people who are in financial bondage, but also for people living a debt-free life to encourage them to sustain the lifestyle. So I agree with the chairman that the audience for this book is very wide. And this is a book that I believe the time has come for people to know how to live a debt-free life. So I want to thank Simon for being thoughtful to put this book out at this time, a well-researched book to liberate people from this modern day slavery. And again, thank you for giving us another solution capsule, this time around, not for health, for living a debt-free life. Debt-free life. So I want to thank you, and thank you also for the opportunity to be part of this great event. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, sir. Mr. NSCB, Chairman, Fidelity Bank. I can see hands are clapping. I can see your videos. Thank you so much. We appreciate you again and again. Auntie Mo, as she's fondly called, former chairman, Access Bank, is here to grace us with her presence and her words of kindness and encouragement. Please welcome her with me warmly. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Joyce. And congratulations, Simon and IJ, my beautiful IJ. You've been a pillar of support right from day one that I know you. I call Pastor Simon, he's my brother from another mother. We go way back, and he's part of my family as I'm part of his. So this is my own joy in reading the book. But what I love most about the book is that it's very simple to read, very simple to understand, and he gives practical examples as to what has happened to him in his own personal life. So it is very, very relatable. And I particularly like what he said about you being the CEO of your financial life. So you have to take your life in your own hands, and it gives you examples of what to do, how not to be in debt. And I also like how he says, you know, when you're planning your financial life, it's about the whole family understanding where you're going and the whole family being part of your plan. So your children also will know that this is what daddy has in mind, and they are brought along the journey. You know, it's about being consistent in whatever you believe in and trying not to live beyond your means. So I'll leave the review to the book reviewers, but just to say that it is something for everybody to read. I'm going to get the book for my school, because you can start being financially disciplined right from a very, very young age. And because it's very, very simple to read, I just love how it flows very, very, it flows very, very simply. I don't have any other word. So congratulations, Pastor Sai, as we call you, the whole of KRC and CKA are behind you. You're very supportive, you're very dependable, and you know, you're a blessing to us, and perhaps that's why God has continued to bless you. And IJ, well done. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you so much, Auntie Mosun Bello Olusoga. We are so grateful to you. Educator, role model, mentor, thank you for your kind words. And she has said she will buy for her book. Oh, she's muted now. I can't hear what she's saying. Jenny, can you help me unmute Auntie Mo, please?
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, apologies, sincere apologies. Our author, our Oga at the top today had told us everything was run smoothly and quickly. We will not waste the time of our distinguished personalities. These are important people coming. So make sure everything is tip top, sharp, sharp, sharp. And everybody knows he's a man that likes to do things quickly and in order. Thank you so much. Our next speaker is a dear friend of the author, a sister in, if I dare say, sister in finance and ensuring that people grow. A sister who is committed, actually completely committed to people. She serves as the Managing Director of Financial Institutions Training Center. She is a brand queen, one who believes your voice should be heard, especially if you have something to say. And since our author has something to say, of course, she's here to celebrate and to share her kind words. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, I know she's here because I can see her. At least I can see her on my screen. We want to welcome Mrs. Chizo Malize. Okay. It's possible she stepped away for a moment and we'll be right back. Okay, her sound is on. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you very much. You would need to unmute me.
Yes, we can hear you now, ma'am. It's loud and clear.
Okay. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It's such an honor and privilege to be a part of this session. It's also a tin of pride for us at FITC to see that our very distinguished faculty member of over 30 years has taken all of the things that teaching in the class in the institution in writing. Pastor Simon Arenonu is one of the most distinguished faculty members that we have at FITC. And in promoting the knowledge around credit risk management, he has consistently helped individuals as well as organizations to be able to manage risks around credit, around borrowing. What that has done is it has helped organizations whom he has helped their staff through knowledge manage and coordinate risk assets that they create consistently. And we know how important it is for businesses to be able to have access to finance, be able to borrow, and be able to repay. So he's not only strengthening through knowledge these individuals who come into the banking institutions and financial institutions to borrow so as to grow their economies. He's also made significant contribution to ensuring that the banks and organizations that he has taught over the period at our institution are also able to manage their risk assets as well as stabilize the banks. And we already know how important that is also to the general economy. We're proud of what you do, we're proud of what you've done, and we're extremely delighted to be associated with you. And like our distinguished managing director, Mr. Kayo Peter said, we do not know how you do all of these things, but we are just very, very proud of you and pray that God continues to give you abundant blessings, give you strength, give you more vision to do more and continue to exploit and bless the world. Thank you so much. And we are always here for you. Thank you.
Thank you. Mrs. Chizo Malize, thank you, thank you, thank you. She has given us some citation on our author for those of us who have not known that he's a teacher, but it's almost impossible not to know. You can't sit with him for 2 to 3 minutes and not know this man is a teacher. Teacher of money, teacher of life, teacher of the Bible, teacher of marriage, teacher of happiness, teacher of joy, teacher of health, teacher of prayer. I'll leave it there for now. Thank you so much, sir, for doing this for us. It's not every time that we find leaders who are willing, able, and ready to lift up generations that are coming behind them. Another video to tell you more about the book, Financial Freedom. very brief message from Wes Bow, the publishers of the book. This book has already been sold across the world. It has been hot cake already. For those who are willing, ready and able to buy, don't worry, in a few minutes, we'll open the floodgates so you can buy for yourself, your communities, your families, your schools, libraries around you, and we will all read so that we can enjoy debt-free living. The Dean of Faculty, Caleb's University, and former President, Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, is here, and he's ready to give us his remarks. Please welcome with me Professor Segun Ajibola.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let me thank God for the life of my dear friend and brother, Pastor Simon Aranona. There are occasions when the message is as important as the messenger. And I think this is one of the occasions. Because we are a country that talks so much and does so little. But when it comes to walking the talk, Simon stands out. And we do know that when we talk about credit in a banking environment, it is not a job for the boys. The men distinguish themselves from the boys. And when we look at what Simon has done, is doing, and by the grace of God, we'll be doing, we see a man that walks the talks. To communicate credit matters to the whole world, it requires a man with untainted integrity, goodness of character, in personal life, in professional life. Simon stands out as one example from the crowd. So for him, communicating again to the whole world with this book, which I'm very, very eager to get my own copy and read, I think it is congratulations to Simon. Simon leads by example, and is one example to this incoming generation. It is my prayer that God that has endowed you not only with skills and competencies, with the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, but with goodness of character, with integrity that is undoubted, we continue to empower you to do more to serve him and humanity. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, whatever Simon will have communicated in this book, it is for the betterment of this incoming generation. And I join others in recommending the book to the entire global space. Simon, my friend, personal friend, family friend, please accept the congratulatory message of my entire family, who you know very well, in doing another human's job. And God will enable you to do more and more. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you so much, Professor Segun Ajibola. Thank you for your kind words. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support. And thank you for the purchase that you are preparing to make for you and the community around you. I remember the first time that the author spoke to me about the book earlier in the year. And when I asked him how much the book was going to be sold, he said to me, "Joyce, this project is not about money. It's about giving back." This guy was looking at him. I said, "Okay, I know it's about giving back, but you have to make something." He said, "No, I have to spread this word. God is depending on me to be a voice to people so that they are not kept in financial bondage." So this is an effort of love, an effort of grace not an effort of profit making, which is rare. I know your hands are there. Please applause once again, our author. So many people would like to say a thing or two. So since the microphones are muted, there's so many congratulatory messages in the chat. If you can scroll to the chat at any time, you will see several congratulations. People are writing their names and telling us, saying congratulations to the author, congratulations to the author and his family. For those who are yet to chat, please, when you chat next, tell us where you're chatting in from, because we know that people here from across the world. So after writing your name, tell us what city you have clicked in from. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you again. A dear friend and brother to our author, Director Legal Services, Central Bank of Nigeria. He has been standing by for his remarks, but I think the network keeps throwing him in and out. A moment here, a moment there. We'll give him a moment to come back. Whilst we wait for him to return, and we also await the presence of the President, African Finance Corporation, please allow us to play one more video. Oh, I see he's here. I see he's here. So let me welcome him up. He's back here. Okay, Jennifer, let's play the video to allow.
Sir, you're unmuted.
Financial Freedom is a book that is extremely practical in the sense that as you read each chapter, you should begin to take notes of what you have learned in each chapter. For example, the first chapter is talking about highways to financial bondage. And he lists 21 highway points that can put you in financial bondage. If you read them and you find out that two, three are the ones where you are guilty, immediately write it down. Immediately make up your mind that these errors that are capable of putting me into bondage, I need to retract from it. I need to get out of it. I need to stop it. You need to write it down. So it's a book that you put down and then begin to put in practice. That's just one of them. You know, we have a chapter there that is talking about how to build wealth, how to build personal wealth. That chapter teaches you what I call the 10 C's of building personal wealth, which includes capacity, capital, which includes character, you know. All those 10 C's of building personal wealth, they are as relevant as ever. If people have built wealth using these 10 indices, why don't you apply them? So you look at the 10 indices and ask yourself, wait a minute, of these 10, how many of them do I lack? For example, the issue of character. Character means you keep to your commitment. You borrow money, you say, I will pay it in 6 months' time, you must deliver whether it is convenient for you or not. And you must, if you are through a problem, you go to your lender. You don't run away from your lender. So character is you. Like I always say, capital is not scarce. What is scarce is character. If you have character,
Oh my. Can you hear me? If you can, please say yes in the chat. We have before us the Managing Director, Development Bank of Nigeria. Please welcome with me, Mr. Tony Okpanachi, for his remarks. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. Let me use this opportunity to congratulate Simon for this very interesting book, Financial Freedom. I think it's in line with Simon's character since I've known him. Simon has been very, very, very consistent. And coming from somebody who has been in the practice of lending money for over 30 years, I think he was an authority to be able to talk on issues that have to do with financial freedom, especially about lending and how not to get yourself entrapped in debt. So I will recommend this book to everybody. Simon is coming from a very practical perspective, and Simon is also coming from a very simplistic perspective. So whether you are a financial expert, whether you are not, or whether you're just a simple person trying to run your business, trying to live your life on the best basis, Simon is always very, very as explicit to us in a way that everybody will see clearly that you can live a debt-free life. So Simon, I congratulate you very much on this, and I wish you all the best. And I can assure you that I will also make this book available to people around me, and especially those I mentor. Thank you very much, everyone, and congratulations once more, Simon.
Thank you, Mr. Okpanachi, making the book available to everyone around him, especially those who he mentors. A great man leaves a legacy for others. Appreciate you, sir. Thank you so much. Allow me welcome back Mr. Kofo Alada, who is Director of Legal Services, Central Bank of Nigeria, for his remarks. Welcome, sir.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Well, we cannot separate, the author from the book. The author, Pastor Simon Aranono, a very humble person who is passionate about everything he does. And he has demonstrated this in the book that is being presented today. Having gone through the book, I can confirm that anybody who decides to live by the ideals espoused in this book will forever be free from debt. It is one thing to read. It's another thing to actually cogitate, practicalize, and live by the spirit and letters of the book. For me, from a vantage position, having superintended the drafting and release of certain regulatory documents around the subject matter of this book. I like to say that it's a book that is coming so well recommended. And I've had, without the permission of the author, to have invited into this presentation persons who will carry the messages in this book to the corners of Nigeria in their bid to educate the consuming public in the financial industry. You know, what we have in the book is actually a better literature explaining the regulation released by the Central Bank of Nigeria in December 2019. You know, a lender is supposed to understand the psychology of the borrower. The borrower also is expected to understand what he's getting himself into. You know, we will be recommending this book to any potential borrower, also all credit administrators in Nigeria.
Okay, Father.
I want to say that I want to thank Mr. Pastor Aranono for putting together this book, you know, which is very, very interesting, very simple to follow, easy to read and digest. So what we'll be expecting soon is for him to try to step this down to the a few local languages in Nigeria so that the people we're trying to bring in via financial inclusion will also benefit from this great experience. I pray that we continue to have Pastor Aaron around to continue to give us this diet for a long time to come. Thank you, Pastor, for doing this. We're recommending this in-house, and we're recommending it also to all the regulators around. It is not only in the banking industry that you borrow. Even if you borrow from the industry, you take it to other parts. The capital market is there. So we'll be recommending this. Thank you, Pastor, once again, for giving us this. May you live long. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kofo Alada. You've brought another aspect and perspective to it, converting to local languages. I know we also can count on your support to make this happen. This is a project of altruism for the betterment of humanity. We will appreciate every support necessary to bring in the right people, to put it in the right dialect to go around Nigeria. Thank you so much, Mr. Kofo Alada. Thank you, thank you, and thank you again. If your hands are there, please appreciate. We're going to have this book, Financial Freedom in Languages. Yay! Dr. Ayola Oduton is standing by to give his words of encouragement and support. He is the chairman of MOBNG Nigeria Limited, and he's a beloved brother of the author. Please welcome him with us. I'm trying to unmute you from here, please. Yes, we can hear you now, sir.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure and an honor to be at this book launch. Pastor Aranono is somebody who I respect very much for his humility and his wealth of experience, and to have put all those thoughts into this book, I think is really quite commendable. He's an excellent teacher. And as a result, I think I recommend this book to all those that are young at heart and present and future leaders.
Ah, we've been muted, sir. Please unmute, sir. Please unmute. Okay. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry, one more attempt, sir, please. Just click on mute. Sorry about this. Technology. We are blessed with technology. It has brought us together from across the world, and today it will be continue to be a blessing to us. If you just click on the microphone sign again, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, we can hear you now. Yes.
Finally. Okay. So I would say this is an excellent book for all young at heart and present and future leaders. I wish I had this book when I was 20, because a lot of the mistakes I have made in my career would have been avoided. And I'll definitely recommend this first to my children. It's a must read for them. And I recommend it for all those that are young and aspiring for their future, because this actually is a book that could create a lot of value throughout the life.
Thank you so much, sir. I do not know why your mic has gone off again. We're trying to get you back on with sound. And we will
Yes. Thank you very much, Simon. I wish you the very best. Congratulations on this great book. And I pray that it touches millions of lives. Thank you.
Oh my apologies, I didn't realize my sound was off. Our very beloved Chairman Access Bank, believer in this project, she had said she has some things to say, and say she shall. Please welcome Mrs. Dere Awoshika.
Good morning, everyone. I want to thank God for setting this date and being able to bring us all together to witness the occasion, especially in the times that we're in, the COVID-19 pandemic. I haven't known others for decades, like my previous chair said, Mrs. Mosun, and several other people. I've known him for just a couple of years, and many things bind us together. And one of the things that I've seen is his eyes are set like a flint. He's not deterred by the heavy duty schedule that he has on his desk as ED, large enterprises in the back of industry. So he still finds room to be able to put his passion, his calling to practice, having known clearly that without knowledge, people perish. So this is a book of knowledge to all. And I want to also borrow from the MD of, indefatigable MD of the Bank of Industry, Mr. Pouton, that he's a book of knowledge in terms of financials. And he doesn't want to keep this to himself, so he's bringing them one by one. But this particular one appeals to me greatly, and I congratulate you, your wife, and the entire family that you are able to answer to the needs of not just individuals, but indeed institutions, like the legal director from CBN said. It's both to the creditors and to the borrowers. And when you scan through all the contents of the book, the word freedom is the opposite of bondage. So if you adhere to it, you'll be free from bondage. The good thing in the book is that it speaks of the various steps that takes you out of bondage. And that makes it easy when translated, as others have suggested, to make people to have a diary of the do's and the don'ts of financials. I want to thank God that this is able to be put in place. I want to also thank God that everybody across, as I look at participants, are both borrowers and creditors. Because sometimes the institution of borrowing have a fiduciary responsibility to ensure that there is absolute and transparent knowledge on the capacity to be able to be free from financial bondage. And I want to sincerely thank God, Pastor Simon Arananu, that you have not kept experiential knowledge to yourself. You have not allowed the demands of your office to keep you from releasing the book at this time. At this time, because this is a time where every creditor across the globe have decided to review the approach to take in making sure that everyone that is borrowing from them become free from financial bondage. I thank God for that, and I salute your brilliance in bringing this to pass. Congratulations, and God bless.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, ma'am. Thank you for being here. Thank you for words of encouragement and support. And indeed, the book will go around the nation and the populace will be educated, enlightened, and empowered, just as is the desire of our author. If your hands are there, please appreciate Mrs. Berry Awosuka, Chairman, Access Bank. One more video before we welcome our keynote speaker and unveil the book and open it up for us all to purchase and share. What more is there in the book Financial Freedom? Please keep your eyes on the screen. Sound. Jenny, sound. Sound, please. We have sound.
To take notes of what you have learned in each chapter. Financial Freedom is a book that is extremely practical. In the sense that as you read each chapter, you should begin to take notes of what you have learned in each chapter. For example, the first chapter is talking about highways to financial bondage. And it lists 21 highway points that can put you in financial bondage. If you read them, and you find out that 2, 3 are the ones where you are guilty, immediately write it down. Immediately make up your mind that these errors that are capable of putting me into bondage, I need to retract from it. I need to get out of it. I need to stop it. So you need to write it down. So it's a book that you put down and then begin to put in practice. That's just one of them. You know, we have a chapter there that is talking about how to build wealth, how to build personal wealth, That chapter teaches you what I call the 10 C's of building personal wealth, which includes capacity, capital, which includes character. You know, all those 10 C's of building personal wealth, they are as relevant as ever. If people have built wealth using these 10 indices, why don't you apply them? So you look at the 10 indices and ask yourself, wait a minute, of these 10, how many of them do I lack? For example, the issue of character. Character means you keep to your commitment. You borrow money, you say, I will pay it in 6 months' time, you must deliver in 6 months' time, whether it is convenient for you or not. And you must, if you are genuinely running through a problem, you go to your lender. You don't run away from your lender. So character is you. Like I always say, capital is not scarce. What is scarce is character. If you have character, you already have massive capital. People will trust you. They will give you, if you're a trader, they will give you goods on credit, knowing fully well you will pay when you sell. If you are a manufacturer, banks will lend you money. If you are an importer, banks will lend you money. Many banks are lending to people loan money based on their integrity. No bank lends money if you have everything but lack character. So the beginning point of building wealth is to be trustworthy, is to be able to keep to your words. Nobody can ever build wealth if he lacks character.
Jenny, please let's have the next video. Thank you.
So this is about solutioning, but solution from the financial perspective to help people who have entered into financial bondage through excessive credit or bad use of credit, or those who are already on the threshold of entering that, who need to avoid the crisis of debt bondage, or those who are actually managing to keep wealth, to preserve wealth and make wealth so that they can be able to know how to manage wealth. So it's about financial knowledge, financial education that is meant to assist people to know how to use money. Because the truth is that everybody uses money. Everybody earns money. Lawyers, engineers, doctors, we all work for money. But very few know much about money. And so this is about financial education to enable everybody to know about money, building wealth, saving money, making investments, and preparing for a life of retirement.
Thank you.
Thank you. More insights into the book. Our chairman today is a man who understands this thing called money. He has used money well. He has shown money how to support businesses. He was once, perhaps, a small business, but he has grown into such a large enterprise. This book might be targeted at people who are in the small, medium, and even micro business space, but coming from a man who has seen it, he has understood the entire value chain and how indeed we can make money work for us and have it bear fruits. He's a nation builder. No wonder he's wearing green today. He believes in the growth and development of this nation, Nigeria. Please welcome the chairman, Nest Oil Group, Mr. Ernest Obiejesi Azudialu. Welcome, 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 sir. Oh, please, sir. I'm trying to unmute
okay.
You from my... Yes, we can hear you now. Thank you.
Oh, you can hear me now. Thank you very much. Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I feel honored to be part of this event today. First of all, I want to thank the Almighty God for making today possible and for letting us live our life today to be part of this event. Despite all these days of the pandemic where people have to live different lives from what we are used to. I would want to use this opportunity to, first of all, congratulate my brother, Simon Anono. I call him Pastor. And this is a friend and a brother I've known for many years. I mean, I think our friendship or our relationship dates back to many years when I was starting to build Nest Oil. You see, I feel also good, you know, having the opportunity to be a keynote speaker in this book launch. You see, from what I have seen, it's not just a book. It's a lifesaver. It's a book or an instrument that can transform people's lives. Something that will give people the opportunity to actually see or live some of the things that they do not understand that it happens to them every day. Everybody enjoys money. Money, people lose money. People live their lives, happiness. When you're not happy, when you're angry, a lot of things depend on, you know, what money can do in your life. But we never thought of looking at some of these things, you know, in the practical sense of it, how it impacts on our daily lives. When I started flipping through this book, I started seeing myself in the book. I started seeing some of the mistakes I made in life, even as a student, even as a small boy, even when I was starting business. You see some of the things that impacts your life in such a way that you definitely see one or two or three or even five things you can learn from reading this book. It's a very great book. It is good for children. If your children read it, or if the parents read it, you will know how to direct your children. You'll be able to teach them how to live their lives without looking for designer's items. Without, you know, being a little kid, you want to wear Versace, you want to wear this and that. And all these are, you know, habits that sometimes parents inculcate in children. And they grow up with these things and then start doing it as part of their lives. This is how this bondage starts. This is how you start living above your means. This is how children start behaving or feeling that they must compare themselves with others. If everybody's wearing this, I must wear that. So this book teaches you about how to bring up your children, even what to teach them when they are kids. Then as an adult, as a worker, you learn also from it. How do you want to save money? How do you want to live your life? How do you even want to handle financial issues? Because before you know it, you are in debt. You start your life going around the kind of bondage where you are so unhappy about a lot of things, and you see people knocking at your door, you find that you cannot pay your rent. There are so many things that this book can teach you. One of the most important things is that the book makes you also review the life you've lived and some of the things that you are now going to meet as challenges, you know, in your, I mean, your future lives. I want to give one little example that I noticed about my own life. Let me use myself as an example. I said, I saw myself inside the book. I have a very, you know, very good, lovely wife that God blessed me with. And I know that whenever I go shopping with my wife, she's the one that doesn't like to buy things. She likes good things of life, but she doesn't like to buy them the way I want her to buy them. So I noticed that whenever we go into the shops, my wife will always be going to where they, you know, where they have sale. I said, no, I said, these ones are the old things, so don't go to that side. Look at the new. He said, please, no, honey, please leave me. This is the place I want to be. Look, I want to look at it because do you know that these ones, the price were this high before. Now it is cheap. That's why I'm going to buy them. They are the same thing. I keep telling her, I said, these ones are old fashioned. They are 3 years old. You don't need them. Anything they put on sale, they might also be selling them the same price that they put them, you know, before. They are deceiving you. She keeps doing that. And she goes to buy things that are on sale. And I've not actually put these things together. But one thing I've learned from this book is that I now found out from this book that actually going to buy things that are on sale is actually one of the ways you can not only satisfy that urge for the brand you want or the style you want, but also buy something other people have already paid the money for advert, money for the CNN show, money for the, you know, people that modeled it. People have paid for that. So the price is now reduced. So it's one of the ways you can also live a life by conserving and keeping your money for more important things. If you would like to buy, if you are fashionable and, you know, things like that. So for me, the book now taught me to expose that part of, you know, my life that I never understood very well, that this is actually what was going on. Then if you go further, when you read other chapters of the book, you start seeing the ideas of how to build businesses and what you need to watch out for when you are building business. When your business, you know, when you want to start a new business, you don't need to go and start the business with borrowed funds. You must first of all start with equity. Because when you start with, you know, with equity, that's the only time you are going to now say, okay, as you take prospects, you can then now borrow money. Okay. And when you now borrow money and the business is expanding, you will now start learning how do I conserve my profits so that I can use them to also expand for the future. So for me, this book is an eye-opener, and I must recommend this book to, you know, both my colleagues in Nest Oil Group and even the, you know, the young graduates that we mentor, the people that we call a graduate trainees that we gather every year to train them for the future of the company. I have to recommend this book to them. And more importantly for me is that this book reveals my early lives in business, how I grew the group, how I was able to, you know, build a company, expanded so much with a lot of loans, a lot of borrowing from the banks. And when the environment or the economy is not favorable, you know, to some of those businesses, you start seeing businesses being shaky, you start seeing bankers also, you not being able to service your loans and whatever. But you see, the most important thing that as you invest in on your borrowed funds, you need to understand that those funds are investments. You know, monies you're taking for investment. And those investments, you must be patient enough to make sure that you grow them to be able to pay those debts. So seeing myself, you know, reading this book and looking at myself from where I'm sitting today, it shows me clearly that what Pastor Simon has done is that he has looked at the, you know, the practical life of most Nigerians, even in these hard times, put it together and let people read and see how this book affects them in one way or the other. It has touched my life. I mean, a lot of things I've reviewed them. Not that I don't know these things, but I have to review them practically. I have to look at, you know, how it affects me and my children, even my friends. And I'm sure that when you put this, you know, the items in this book in practice, your life will change. You'll find out that you're going to be a happier person. I mean, I can go on and on. I mean, give you practical examples, but the most important thing for me is that I'm part of this event. I feel that given this opportunity, that I will not only congratulate Simon, but try to make sure that I make this book, you know, available to quite a lot of people that, you know, that are important to me, to also make them understand, including my children too, to make them understand that you can actually create your own future by making sure that you save yourself from financial bondage and have what we call financial freedom. So finally, you know, I once again want to, you know, congratulate my brother and also, thank him for being part of my life. Thank him for being there. He gave me a lot of advices when I was coming up. He advised me a lot, you know, especially in the, you know, in the way to also make sure that you run a watertight financial institution by making sure that also people, you know, who work for you and also people who advise you financially at once, so I'm not going to, you know, lead you astray. So I thank you, Simon, for that opportunity, and I thank Almighty God for making it possible for us to cross our paths, and I ask God to continue to bless you and give you more wisdom to even write more books for the future. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you, Mr. Keynote Speaker. Thank you, and God bless you too, and being such a strong support and encouragement to us. And when you say, you know, I'll recommend the book, we know what you mean, that you're going to make sure the book is in the hands of these people. Thank you for spreading the word and sharing of your own personal experiences. I would never look at sales the same way again in my entire life. Thank you. Mr. Ernest Obiejesi Azudelu, Chairman Nest Oil Group. From one Ernest to another Ernest, the Chairman Fidelity Bank is standing by to unveil the book so that we are now all ready to purchase. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Welcome, sir.
Thank you. The moment that we have been waiting for is here. Ooh,
yes.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor and privilege to unveil this extremely unique book, Financial Freedom, for Use and Benefit of Humanity. As you all heard about the book from all the various speakers, this is a book that we must have. It's a 360 degree training, as we've been told, on financial management. It is very reader friendly. It contains great lessons for everyone, both young and old. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is highly recommended for everybody. And it gives me great pleasure and honor to right now unveil this book in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm saying amen on behalf of everyone whose mic is muted. You know what? I am going to unmute everybody to shout a loud amen. So everybody, let's go. You can see that you can unmute yourself right now. Let's hear the amen. Let's hear the amen. Let's hear the amen.
Congratulations, thank you.
Allow me to show you for the first time, for those of us who have not seen the face of our author and his dear wife. They are smiling, they are happy, their hearts are full of gratitude that all these wonderful people, unfortunately, we couldn't call so many names, but they are grateful that you are here. They are happy,
they are encouraged.
And I'm almost tempted to say on behalf of the author that another book is coming soon. Don't worry, another book is coming soon. In the comments, we've been seeing people giving testimonials about the past book, and this one is about to do same. So somebody is asking the question, how can I purchase? If you're asking that question, please put it in the chat. Say, how can I buy? How can I purchase? How can I purchase? How can I purchase? How can I purchase? I want to see the comments first. When I see the comments, I'll tell you how. If I don't see the comments, I can't tell you. I'm sorry. How can I purchase? How can I purchase? Where are the comments? Yes, they're coming in. How can I purchase? Thank you. Jenny, let's show them how. Ah, people are saying, I want to buy many. I want to purchase tons. We're about to show you. Jenny, please let's put up the slide and show our wonderful audience, wonderful people who are taking our time to be here, how to purchase. How to purchase, very simply. Jenny, how to purchase? How to purchase the flyer, how to get the book. The flyer, how to get the book. It's a one-page flyer, how to get the book. How to get the book. Somebody said, hope there is bulk purchase discounts. Believe me, in fact, there's more than bulk purchase discounts. Hey, let me tell you what is about to happen. Whilst we're trying to get the flyer up, I will tell you. This book, I asked my Oga, as an author myself of two books, I said, Oga, this book cannot be selling for less than 8K now, because see the quality of print. We know what's happening this COVID season, the cost of printing. Even glue became so expensive for book producers. And they were saying they couldn't import from China. So the prices went up. So I said, Oga, this book, now, thank you. He said, no. It has to get into the hands of the people. The flyer is coming up. 30% discount for every purchase on this book, bringing it to an unimaginable price of 4,000 naira only. Only. I know you're clapping. You're smiling. Your heart is happy. 4,000 naira only. And there's more. For every purchase made between now and the next 24 hours, meaning before the 24th of August, you will get deliveries free. Absolutely free. The book will be delivered to you for free. Can you imagine? We're not even saying, oh, please clap, 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 clap. For orders that are made today and tomorrow, you will get your deliveries free as long as you're within any state capital, any of the 36 states of the country. We will also put up the link to those who need to buy from the foreign countries, those who are resident outside Nigeria. We'll put up the link to show you how you can purchase from Amazon and other links. The book is in Barnes and Nobles, and we are grateful and glad. Ambassadors has an Access Bank account where you can pay 4,000 naira only. And please make use of the phone numbers that are put on there. You will send your proof of payment to Pastor Mike. And Pastor Mike and his team will ensure that the book gets to you within a number of working days. You just give us some time to make sure the logistics are well taken care of and your books will be delivered.
My brother,
to you.
How are you?
If your hands are free, sir. Or if you're not free, please go to the chat and put in there your
this
hand
man,
clap.
How are you,
put
sir?
In there your hand clap. Put in there your hand clap. 4,000 naira only. We're going to put in the chat as well the payment details for some people who want to copy and paste, because I can imagine that some people want to start buying already. Somebody says here, I have been able to purchase the book on Amazon Kindle. As somebody says in the comments, says, I have been able to purchase the book on Amazon already. Wow. For all my devices. Big congratulations to the author. As a young person, this knowledge of financial freedom is very important so that errors are easily avoided. Fantastic discount. God bless you always. People are buying from across the world. Thank you. Thank you. It is on your screen. It is on your screen and we'll keep it rolling. We'll put the information in the chats. Ladies and gentlemen, we are so grateful and glad. But before we welcome the author to give his final words for our evening or for our morning, afternoon, depending on where you are in the world, please allow us to play this last video that tells us even more about the book, Financial Freedom. After that, we will hear the voice of the author. Jennifer, let's play this video together.
Five common relatives come to us. They come to us to ask for financial help. We lend them money. We give, sometimes we just give them money and say, look, take this one. We can afford to dash you this one. But the truth of the matter is that anytime we consistently dash people money,
Every time you continue to give people money and they keep coming to you to ask for money, you are not helping them. You cannot keep dashing people money forever. It's like they're saying, if somebody wants fish, instead of continuously giving the person fish, teach him how to fish. Teach her how to fish. This book is teaching people how to fish.
Teaching people how to fish. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with joy and honor and gladness that I welcome the man with a large heart, a man who has served in the financial services over 3 decades. He is sold out to the cause of humanity and the betterment of people, lenders and borrowers alike. And this time he's spotlighting on borrowers to ensure that nobody lives in financial bondage. Please welcome with me the author, Mr. Simon Aranonu.
Good afternoon, everyone. I want to start by thanking God for his love that I cannot explain, his love that I do not deserve, his mercies that I am not qualified for in any way. But who are we to argue when God has chosen to bless someone? I can only be grateful to the Almighty God for how he has helped me all my life, from a rural village boy, who with illiterate parents, village school, village primary school, village secondary school. And my story is a story of grace. I do not deserve this honor. But God knows how to be able to help people because he knows I have no one to help me. So I want to thank God for helping me, for taking me all over the world and writing to you. I want to also mention that in every problem that everything works together for good for those who love God. So I have passed through challenges in life, financial challenges. You will see that in the pages of this book. And so I was keeping a diary of what I was passing through. And that diary formed the basis of this book. And so if you are passing through challenges right now, just know that I will trust God with you that one day your diary, which I hope you are keeping, will become the next book we are going to read. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Don't give up. Never say it's over, because God has a plan. He can use your challenges to help somebody in the future. So that's on that basis, I want to say I'm grateful to God for the pains, which have become gains now, for the lessons that I have learned, which I believe it will help people all over the world, and we have to document them, on paper. I want to also thank our chairman, my chairman, Malam Aliu Diko, the chairman of Bank of Industries, for his unwavering support and commitment. He's been here from the very beginning. He has always supported our initiatives. I'm very grateful. I'm grateful to all the members of the board of directors of Bank of Industry who are all fully represented here. Executive directors, all our directors who are here, of course, the top management is here. Even our former directors, executive directors, are all here in this meeting. And I'm grateful to all of you for being able to honor us today. I want to thank my MD very specially. He's always there. I don't know how he makes complex things to always look simple. When you panic, he will say, "Simon, calm down." He has a way of always being there and providing the guidance and support and inspiration. I'm grateful to him. Thank you so much, my MD, and all the top management staff and all our staff who are here. I want to express my gratitude to all the speakers. I can not thank you enough. I am so grateful to the chairman of Fidelity Bank and my boss and my teacher, and who has been guiding me, who was my chairman of my wedding about 30 years ago, who has my sponsor. So he has always been there. I want to thank every one of us. I want to thank Mr. Dr. Ernest Obiejesi, who gave the keynote speech. I want to thank the former chairman of Access Bank, Auntie Mo, my boss, Peggy 91, and Mrs. Mosumbelo Lushoga. I want to thank also the current chairman of Access Bank, Dr. Mrs. Awoshika, for her wonderful talk. I want to appreciate very deeply and sincerely the chairman of Amobim, Dr. Ayola Odunton. I want to appreciate Sumaila Zuberi, the president of AFC, African Finance Corporation. I think they were trying to spotlight him, but something technically went wrong, but I think I know he's here. I want to thank the MD of Development Bank of Nigeria, Tony Opanashi, for his wonderful talk. I want to appreciate the Director of Legal Services of Central Bank of Nigeria, my boss, and our regulator, Oga Kofo, for his wonderful talk. I want to, who else am I missing? I don't want to miss anybody. I know everybody, if I miss you, then you know that I have made a mistake. I shouldn't make a mistake. I want to appreciate the MD of FITC, Financial Institutions Training Center, Chizoba Malise, for her wonderful talk. And I want to appreciate Professor Shegu Ajibola, who is the former president of chairman of the Chadha Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, for his wonderful talk. I'm deeply grateful for everyone. For those, I know that so many people are in this meeting. I am deeply grateful, very, very grateful. Many people have joined from all over the world. Those, God, we honor you, like the announcer has said, if you are not in Nigeria, please buy on Amazon. It's already available both on Kindle and on hard copies. I'm pretty grateful. I want to thank Pastor J.T. Kalejaye, who did the opening prayer, the regional evangelist of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, who is also the special assistant to Pastor E.A. Adeboye, our general overseer, who led the opening prayers. Pastor Kalejaye, I'm most grateful. I'm indeed grateful to every one of you. I cannot thank all of you enough. Just help us to continue to send the good news all over the world that indeed people should borrow if they have to borrow, and if they borrow, they must make sure they pay. Payment, make sure you retain your family name, make sure you don't borrow when you don't have to, and if you must borrow, use the money well and pay your creditor. And by the grace of God, it shall be well with all of us. I'm deeply grateful. We have now 3 minutes over the time we promised you, and I need to stop here. Thank you so much. I want to end by saying I want to thank my wife, who has been with me for 30 years. For 30 years, this wonderful lady has been coping with me and tolerating me. And believe you me, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., she wakes up and she says, "You mean you are still writing? What are you writing?" I say, "I'm writing a book," So, and if she could tolerate me and cope with me and help me, if not for her support, we wouldn't be here. Thank you so much, my wonderful wife. And thank you for all my wonderful children, the 4 of them. God bless you. And may the Lord bless all of you. Thank you so much. And remain blessed.
Amen, amen, amen. Oh, thank you so much, our author. Before we depart, please, I'll ask everyone to please come towards your camera and smile. We're going to take group pictures. If we were together live, we would have taken pictures. So thankfully, technology has helped us to achieve same. So come to your camera, smile, show us your 32, or, well, what's left of the 32. We'll be happy to take it in. Our people are taking pictures row after row. If your camera is not on, please, we request that you put it on now and smile for our memories. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 50 years from now, we'll say we were there when the book Financial Freedom was unveiled and released to the world. I can see all your smiles. Please keep smiling. Keep smiling. We love you. We appreciate you. We are grateful. We see you. We want our author to be able to look at this day, these pictures later and say, wow, they came. They came. If it was a live event, I don't think we'd have had this number of people. We're also live on Facebook. We have hundreds and hundreds of people viewing this event from across the world. We are grateful. We see your smiles. Please don't stop smiling. We're not done. No. Smile. Some people are laughing. We're happy. We are grateful. We're going to project once again how the book can be purchased for those who are still asking for details. We see you. We know you are here. We'd like to say thank you. Thank you for buying for your families, your institutions, your schools, your communities. Thank you. And we just want to say, Baba Eshe. We just want to say, Baba Eshe. We are saying thank you to the Lord for today. I'm about to unmute everybody as we depart to say thank you, to say goodbye, to make your purchases. Jennifer, please just put up on the screen the purchase details. Thank you. Your mics can come on now and shout out thank you, shout out congratulations as we say goodbye. This is the end of the event. Life continues graciously. We are all allowed to unmute our mics now. So say your thank yous and your goodbyes as we wait.
Bye.
Yes, bye. You'll see it on YouTube and on Facebook. Bye.